Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. We just posted the video where we installed the radon system in my sister's house, and we got a comment on from Logan asking how we got the pipe from the mechanical room over the hallway and into the area behind me below the entryway for our second suction point. So I'll attempt to explain that in this video. So, as you can see, we've got our main suction point here. Our pipe runs up and over, and what we've got is a 90. Then we've got another 90 where it turns and faces that direction. We're trying to get up behind the refrigerator in the chase for the B vent for the water heater. So that 90 up there actually has a 2-inch heel on it. So we've got one of these right up there. And then the 2-inch pipe runs across, and then it drops down into this area for our suction point. That's actually right down over there. So this is kind of a mock-up of what I've got above the ceiling here. And then just to show you in here, this is kind of how we came out. So there's my 4-inch hole that I cut, and I'll show you how I decided where to put that. So coming up here, I started out by pulling this carpet back. It's just a tack strip, so you can put everything back. You got some staples to pull here, so not a big deal. So I pulled that out. I measured how far over my floor joist was, and it was 10 inches from here to here. So I took my 1.5-inch hole saw, I cut it through, or drilled the hole through here. Once I did that, it allowed me to measure how far over I wanted to be to cut my 4-inch hole down below. So when I cut that 4-inch hole through the sheetrock, I took and mocked up this section of pipe. I didn't glue anything, but I just mocked it up so that I could get my measurement for the 2-inch pipe going across. So we had the 90 on there. So we had that piece on there. So it allowed me to measure how long I needed to cut this piece. So to get this measurement, I went back to my 1-inch or 1.5-inch hole that I drilled through here. And I took my tape measure. So I measured over to that 2-inch heel across on the other side of the hallway. And then I measured to my 90 that I had mocked up below. And it was something like, I don't know, 50 inches or something, let's say. So that allowed me to get my measurement. Then I took my pipe apart, or my fittings and stuff apart, and I glued this to my 50-inch piece. Once I had that done, I was able to come back in the mechanical room, and I had to get that pipe into position. So I was able to fish it through this bay. I'll try to show you that. So you see the B vent there on the left half of the screen, or the left side of that bay. So I was able to fish that 2-inch pipe over, and you'll see the pipe in the top right half of this of that bay. That's where we go up and turn and go up through the wall or the chase there. But that allowed me to get up through there and then glue everything together. So the second part of Logan's question was, how on earth do we get pipe from the attic above us down through that void space where the chase is? Because that water heater vents right through here and the refrigerator is right there. So what I did is, obviously I couldn't cut an 8-foot piece of 3-inch pipe and fish it down because the roof pitch didn't allow it. So I just cut two smaller chunks and was able to lower it down, glue it in place to my fittings there, and then I had a coupler on it, so I was able to glue down or measure down and glue another piece in. That got me to my final height. Then that's where I 90 up in the attic and then go out. To get away from that B vent exhaust going through the roof. So that's how we did it. I hope that was helpful, Logan. If you guys have any other questions or comments or other videos that you would like to see, please leave them in the comments below. Please also remember to like and subscribe. It helps us out with the Google rankings or the YouTube rankings. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thank you so much for watching.